tap is, young man?
Sure, that's what your mom meant to do.
No, it's not.
Well, if you could just apologize, we could press reset.
What's it going on?
Well, Russell Crowe, so great to see you. Thanks for zooming in from the farm. You must be excited. Your brand new movie, Unhinged, which I watched yesterday, which is incredible, congratulations, is going into cinemas around Australia today. How important is it for you that that's happening?
Well, it's good. I mean, it's fun. You know, that's what I do for a living.
Can you go, please?
This film company, Solstice, is a brand new studio. This is their first release. So they have a whole bunch of research avenues that they can go down. And as soon as this isolation malarkey is over, apart from seeing family and friends that you've missed, what's the next thing the majority of people want to do? And go to the cinema was like 81%. The next part of that research really shocked me because I thought, okay, they want to go to the cinema, but we want to see like a love story, right? Or a comedy or something. And no, human beings, according to the research, want to go to the cinema and have the shit scared out of them by seeing a thriller. I mean, talk about us. I mean, we're just so odd, aren't we? But, you know, that's what the research says.
Ma'am, are you okay?
I'm pretty sure the guy in that truck's following me.
He's road raging.
It's come out in Germany already. It's been number one in Germany for a couple of weeks. Australia today, UK tomorrow. Obviously, if you do go to the cinema, be sensible, wear a mask, you know, take care of yourself and the others around you, you know. But the great thing about the cinema experience, you get to have a situation where all the crazy stuff just happens on the screen, not in your actual life.
I don't think you really know what a bad day is.
But you're gonna find out.
I, for one, am never going to honk my horn at anyone in traffic again because the man, played by you, has taught me a lesson.
Well, there we are. There's just a social responsibility for this film after all.
This is where your first lesson begins. Give me my phone.
What appealed to you about playing this terrifying bloke?
To be brutally honest, very little appealed to me when I first read it, you know? Yeah, I was sort of like really confronted by it and put it down and went, there's no way I'm doing that, you know? But I happened to be in Los Angeles and I was hanging out with friends and a lot of my friends were in the business. So you start talking, what are you doing? What are you reading? You know? So I found myself telling the story of the film I was going to turn down multiple times. And it was about the second or third time I was telling the story of the film and I started to think, oh, this actually sounds really good. The thing that I was rejecting, that there is a truth, it switches then in my mind from being a genre film to being something that really is commenting on the position we find ourselves. Then it became more interesting to me. And just oddly, the way the world has been turning, it's become more and more starkly real that this film directly comments on the position we find ourselves. We've seen over and over again these incidents of mass violence in school shootings or, you know, people taking a gun into a nightclub or breaking a hotel window in Las Vegas, you know, and it's become a regular part of our lives, and that's what this film seeks to really address.
What do you want?
I need you to learn what a bad day really is. I need you to learn how to say sorry.
The director describes the man, which is the character you play, as a bit like the shark in Jaws, in that he just keeps coming. Is this the baddest character you've ever played?
I mean, I did play the right hand of the devil at one point.
True.
In Winter's Tale. You know, that's pretty up there when it comes to bad guys.
Yeah.
But just like a shark, this is a natural predatory instinct for where this guy finds himself mentally at this time. There is no justification. There's no scaffolding underneath his decisions. He has just taken the things that have gone wrong in his life as giving him license to commit this type of violence.
That man stole my phone.
The difficulty in playing a character like this is your lack of relief. You know, you cannot draw on things that you might otherwise draw on. If you're playing a bad guy, you know, you can have so much fun with it sometimes because you push things to such extremes that you can do little asides and stuff with the audience that make something funny and bring about a little bit of relief, you know. But to bring relief with this character, is to completely undermine the seriousness of the situation and the jeopardy that this woman and child are in. So the bluntness of the guy is actually what was difficult. I've been riding love
songs since we broke up. It's great that production's getting back underway here. Do you see your next project maybe being in Australia?
Well, that would be great. All of us that love Australia and work overseas in the business are always trying to find reasons to be at home more. You know, if we can get the country open for film production while other places can't, if we're sensible about that from a government point of view, and if we put in place incentives that give the right sales tool to producers here, then we could actually be looking at an economic recovery led by the film industry. Film takes so many different skilled people, from carpenters to painters to set designers. You know, it's not just actors and directors. And, you know, whether it's in facilities in Victoria, facilities in New South Wales, Sydney, and possibly regionally, you know, and also in Queensland, it may very well be a good idea federally to look at in terms of how we can get a little push on in the creative community and the wider community by using film as an economic recovery tool.
Would you chat to the PM about that?
Oh, if he wants to come and have a chat, yeah. I mean, he has to leave his canola scarf behind.
No shark merch at your house, thanks.
No. But what tends to happen if you come through the gate wearing the merch of some other team, it just burns.
It sets on fire.
Yes, because it's pure air here. It's all South Sydney air.
How's the quarantining been?
Well, Nicole, as it turns out...
I'm asking you that, not on the camera.
Now, you did a wonderful chat with your very good buddy Nicole Kidman on Variety's Actors on Actors the other day, and listening to that, I honestly felt like I was eavesdropping on what should have been just a conversation that you two were having, a little catch-up. In it, you dropped this little nugget. You suggested that you two should do a play, and then you suggested, which I just think is brilliant, Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf?
Who's afraid of Virginia Woolf? Virginia Woolf, Virginia Woolf.
Do you understand how many Broadway producers are now salivating at the prospect that that might one day occur? That would be superb. Is that something you'd really like to do?
Well, I think, you know, Nikki's going to be shooting up here in Byron Bay shortly, which is only like a little way up the road from my place, you know, a couple of hours, but that's nothing in the bush. So, you know, we might get together and might have a chat about that. Working with Nicole in any form is a joyous thing. You know, I got to shoot Boy Erased with her. You know, we were husband and wife in that, and it's just a chemistry that's always been between Nikki and I. And I think it might be a common strength of purpose or something like that. But we were always great mates. And like you say, you know, we were supposed to do that, you know, fancy chat and stick to a script or like, you know, go to a certain place with a conversation. We just started chatting like we're having a cup of tea.
You've been putting some beautiful pictures on your Twitter account of Australian nature, Australian bush, sometimes the flora and fauna. And I wake up every morning, I look at them, they put a smile on my face before I head out for the day. Is that what you're hoping to achieve for anyone else who sees them?
Well, just a little bit of zen.
Yeah.
Because there's a lot of tension around. I don't want to contribute to that. I try very hard not to vent my spleen on social media because it really doesn't help anybody, you know? There's a situation we're in where some people think the way things change and the way things improve is by coming up with the funniest diss or by being the sharpest satirical mind in the group. As much as I love all of that, it's not actually helpful. What's helpful is trying to make people see and understand and expand a common truth. You're going to kill me with this interview, aren't you?
I'm wrapping.
I'm actually busy, Ange. I've got to get back onto the seeding.
Oh, okay. The seeding? What are you seeding?
There's a few paddocks that we've overused in the last few years, so we're sort of ripping them up and fertilising them and then regrafting them, you know?
Very nice. All right, well, this will be my last one. COVID has us all in the same boat. I usually travel an incredible amount, as you know, because I'm back and forth to LA at the time, although I do tend to do short trips. You're away for a bit longer. But I've found it's turned out to be a very special time for me to be at home with my daughter, who's about to become a teenager. Yeah. Are you finding something to cherish about this time as well in the sense of family?
Look, in reality, I started self-isolating about 3 decades ago. I got a very people-intensive job, and between gigs, you know, I like to spend time alone. And 24 years ago or something like that, you know, I bought the place out in the bush, and I've lived here on and off ever since, you know. So I have actually found this time of isolation to be a great privilege. You know, I've been at home since December, and I seriously have not been in Australia for that long, you know, prior to having kids, prior to being married. Yeah. You know, it's sort of, it's a long, long, long time ago since I spent that much time here. So for me, it's been very productive. I've been ticking off a list of things, and obviously because I can be found, other things become more complicated, you know? I'm finding I am just as busy in supposed isolation as I would be if I wasn't. But I get to do it here, and I get to wake up before the sun, and I get to get into that rhythm of the Australian bush. And to me, it's the reason I bought here such a long, long time ago. It just suits me best.
Lovely to catch up with you. The movie is incredible, as I said. Congratulations on it. And it goes into cinemas today. And hopefully see you soon.
Bye-bye.